version of rules for radicals, because liberals have been kicking our butts for about 40 years now. They are absolutely the minority. We are absolutely the majority. And yet they keep winning and pushing their agenda through. So all I could tell you is that we have to start fighting back, and we have to start fighting back hard, hard. And so my idea is that we adopt their ideas. My idea is that we model Jesse Jackson and Al Sharpton and Martin Luther King with civil disobedience. We've got to get to the point where if a company goes woke, we make them go broke. Because I don't think the politicians determine where America goes, where the agenda goes, where the policy goes. It's the corporations who give all the money to the Democrat politicians that are destroying our society. They're giving them permission to destroy us. So we have got to destroy them back. We can't be nice. We can't turn the other cheek. We can't spend our whole lives just hoping someone comes to save us. We've got to take control. We got to take action. So my new book, The Great Patriot Protest and Boycott Book, teaches conservatives how to use protest, boycotts, intimidation, and civil disobedience, just like liberals have done for decades, and they've steamrolled us. They really have. Now we need to play that game, and we need to steamroll them. We really need to become the loud majority. We've been the silent majority far too long, and Jesse Jackson and Al Sharpton and all the liberal activists have been the loud, screaming, nasty, loud minority, and we need to become the loud majority. So I wrote a book to show us how to do it, in 5 minutes a day from your kitchen table or your lazy boy recliner or your office desk. And not only how to do it, but I gave you all the important, valuable, priceless information, the contact information of all the CEOs of the biggest corporations in America. So I've given you, with, you know, literally thousands of hours of research, I've given you the phone numbers, the emails, the mailing address, the social media address, the name of the CEO and the name of the board of directors of all the biggest companies in America that are liberal and woke and insult us and offend us and ignore us every single day. But we do 60% of the spending, so we can drive them into bankruptcy and bring them to their knees. And that's what the Great Patriot Protest and Boycott Book is all about.
Wayne Allen Root with us today. He is the host of the nationally syndicated Wayne Allen Root, Raw and Unfiltered. You hear it each and every day on USA Radio Network. And he's also got the War Raw podcast as well. And RootForAmerica.com is the official website. Go over and pick up this incredibly, incredibly important book. So, Wayne, this is the thing I think is so amazing about this book, is you compiled all the information that people need to be able to go out and storm these corporations like the left does with all the corporations that have been doing that for a lot of years.
Yeah, well, as I said, you know, look, I'm the typical conservative. I'm like the people listening to you right now, James.
Yes.
In that I work every day. I spend my time at the office. I spend my time building my career. I spend my time building my businesses. I spend my time raising four children and a family. And you know, add in going to church on a Sunday morning and a few Little League games, and nobody's got any time to protest. And that's why conservatives, I think, have gotten screwed. That's how they screwed us, because they don't have kids. They live on welfare. Sometimes they live on government jobs, which are 9 to 5. They're off, you know, 2 or 3 days a week. They're off at 5 o'clock every afternoon, maybe 3 o'clock every afternoon if they're a school teacher. They're off the whole summer if they're a school teacher. We don't have that life. We don't have that luxury. So conservatives never have time to do this stuff. So I just made it easy. I just put all the information in my book. It's a 130-page book. You can read it in an hour, hour and a half, and then all the information at the back, the last 30 pages, allows you to spend 5 minutes a day just cut and paste, create one email for a corporate CEO, one, and then cut and paste and use the same one for, you know, five
yes.
a day. Just
yes.
press send. And pretty soon we're going to have a million emails in front of corporate America that say, we're conservatives, we're Christians, and we're proud, and we're not going to buy from you anymore unless you cut out this liberal crap. And I'm telling you, it's going to change the world.
Well, Wayne, every single week I have a former His name is Larry Tracy. He used to work in the Reagan administration, and he always has said, why don't we do, why doesn't conservatives do this? Why don't they figure out a way to get a hold of the major corporations and do exactly what the left has been doing for many of years? And you've done it here. This is just amazing. Talk to me about why you decided that you were going to put this book together.
Well, I mean, because I've never made phone calls, as much as I'm a conservative leader in this country, a thought leader. You know, Bill Cunningham's one of the great conservative radio hosts. He's got the biggest weekend show, and I'm his number one guest, and Bill always says, I'm the greatest conservative thinker in America. Well, that's great, but thinking doesn't get us anywhere, right? You got to take action. And I've personally never called a corporation in my life and said, I'm going to boycott you, I'm going to protest you, I don't like the way you're treating conservatives, I don't like that you take my money, I spend a lot of money at your store, and yet you gave $50 billion to Black Lives Matter, which is a Marxist organization that hates cops and hates white people and hates men and hates America and hates capitalism. And so I've never done that because I have no time to look up all the contact information. So I thought if I go out and find all that information for the average conservative, the average Christian, guess what? You don't have to look it up anymore. It's all right there in my book. And you just open the book and you send the emails or you make the phone calls or you send even snail mail, regular letters, because I got you the physical address as well, or you go to their social media site. I got you their Twitter, their Facebook, and their Instagram site where you can leave messages for everybody to see on that site. They could never hide it. So that's what I did so that everybody has the same advantage now that I've got. Now I got all that information. Now I can do it to my heart's content. It's time for us to be like Martin Luther King. It was good enough for Martin Luther King. It should be good enough for Republicans, conservatives, and Christians, and that is civil disobedience. It's time for us to fight back.
Now, this book is incredibly well written. Talk to me about the writing process for the book.
Well, you know, all my books are always like 300-400 pages, right? This is my 15th book, my 8th bestseller. By the way, it's a number one bestseller, number one in about 15 categories at Amazon. And, I'm very happy and thrilled that conservatives have embraced this book. But when you see the writing process, you know, I don't have a heck of a lot of time, right? I'm such a busy guy. How do you write a book? Well, you know, it's got to be like 2 hours a night, every night for like 3 months, and there's no other way to do it because I work all day. So that's how I write my books, and this one is not 300-400 pages, 130 pages. 30 of it is all the resources you need to call all these CEOs and find their phone numbers and emails. So it's about 100 pages, and so I just sat there and I wrote a stream of consciousness, what I think is happening in America. Basically, the book's about the only issues that matter right now if we're going to save America. There's a lot of issues that matter to conservatives and Christians, and they're all important. But if you want to save America right now, it really comes down to, number one, if there's a communist takeover of America going on. And you got to admit that's what's happening. These aren't liberals. It's a communist takeover, a radical communist takeover of the United States of America, and they hate us, and they want to destroy us. And all you need to do is look at Black Lives Matter or critical race theory or all the people that are being censored at Twitter and Facebook. I'm censored for life. I've been banned for life at Twitter. Can you believe that? So, you know it's a communist takeover because the hallmark of communism is they take away your free speech, they ban you, they censor you, they try and take your job away and starve you. Number two is open borders. That's how they're destroying the United States of America, with open borders and letting in everybody in the whole world, most of whom are socialists, communists, most of whom want welfare for life, and guess who's paying the bill? You and me. And number three, vaccine mandates. That's the end of America. That's it. If you don't want a vaccine, they're going to ruin your life. They're going to isolate you. They're going to take your job away. They're going to starve you. They're going to tell you you could never go in a supermarket again or a retail store or a restaurant, and you're never going to go to a football stadium. You're never going to go to a concert. You never go to a convention. You can't get on a train, a bus, or a plane. They're going to ruin your life over a vaccine that, by the way, does not work. Does not work and is killing people all over the world. This is insanity, and all my friends are policemen and firemen. They're all ready to quit rather than take the vaccine. So you're not going to have enough cops anymore. You're not going to have enough firemen anymore. You're not going to have enough military anymore. You're not going to have enough prison guards anymore. It's a very scary situation. The vaccine mandate is literally going to destroy and break up and divide this country and cause crisis and chaos. When you call 911, there's not going to be anybody to return your call. There will be no answer. So vaccine passport, and the last issue that really matters is rigged elections.
Yes.
You cannot believe that Biden is really the president of the United States. They fixed and rigged the election.
Yes, this is the thing.
It's a joke.
This is the thing, Wayne, that I find so strange, and I'm starting to get a lot of my leftist progressive friends that are starting to understand that it was a worked election, because Joe Biden, this guy couldn't get, you know, anybody to vote for him in the primary. They had to steal the primary from Bernie. And
right.
And then you look at the results, and everybody's like, well, Biden got all these votes. And I'm like, okay, Barack Obama was the most popular politician as far as votes go. You really think all these people went out and voted for Biden? Come on.
Well, look, here in Las Vegas, James, I'm obviously very well known, very popular, the biggest afternoon drive time show.
Yes, indeed.
And Biden came to town about 2 weeks before the election. So this was late October 2020. And Biden comes to town himself. Compare, you know, it's not Trump against Biden, it's Wayne Root against Biden. Biden has a rally, and eight people show up. Eight. Then he has a car parade in the afternoon, and there were 20 cars. Wayne Root, the guy you're talking to, I wasn't running for president. I'm not Donald Trump. I'm just a radio host in Las Vegas. That's my base. I mean, I'm all over the country, but my base is Las Vegas. And I called a rally to counter Biden. I called a car parade to counter Biden. I had no idea who'd show up, right? 10,000 people showed up. 10,000. 3,000 cars, pickups, trucks, most of them filled with 3, 4, 5, 6 people waving American flags and Trump flags. We dominated the Vegas Strip for 3 hours. And do you know how much news coverage we got? None. The media made believe it never happened. I had 3 Trump rallies last year. I, Wayne Root, got 10,000 people apiece to 3 rallies, and the media ignored it like it never happened. But when Biden came to town and he put 12 concentric circles in front of him, and they only filled 6 of them, they said, you know, they wrote tons of media, they got cameras, and the news let off, Biden's in town. There was nobody to go see him. He doesn't have anybody supporting him. He's hated, and yet he was the winner with the most votes in history, 81 million votes. It's the biggest joke. 81 million people voted for a guy with dementia who should have a sign around his neck that says, if I get lost, return me to the White House. Give me a break.
I've never heard that line. That is fantastic, Wayne.
Jill feeds the baby food in the basement with his mask on. So bizarre. It really is a bizarre situation. And I think we all need to be asking a really interesting question. Forget the humor for a minute about Biden being a, you know, kind of a brain-dead zombie with dementia. I feel bad for him. I mean, let's face it, it's a terrible thing, and I wish he didn't have dementia, but he does. So let's ask a question. If Biden's a dummy, who's the ventriloquist? Who's the real president? Who's cutting off his microphone? When he speaks, he starts to go off into dementia la-la land, and he dribbles and mumbles like a baby, and they shut the mic off. When anyone asks him a question they know he can't answer, they shut the mic off. Well, this is the president of the United States, the commander of the military, and the leader of the free world. So shouldn't someone be asking who's more important than him that shuts the mic off? Who makes that decision? Who says turn off Joe Biden's mic? Whoever that is, that's the real president of the United States, folks, because it isn't Joe Biden.
We've got Wayne Allen Root with us today. The book is The Great Patriot and Protest Boycott Book. He joins us today here on the telephone. Well, one of the things, and one of your good friends, Donald Trump, I see you guys, you know, I see all these photos of you guys. I see you guys everywhere. You know, nobody was shutting the mic off for Trump.
No, Trump's his own man, and Trump never shuts up. So you have a real problem if you want to shut Trump up, because he never shuts up. He's like me. I never shut up, and I say whatever's on my mind, and I don't care who it offends, because it's the truth. It doesn't matter if you offend people. Look, I'm an SOB, James, son of a butcher. And my dad, the butcher, had a lot of common sense.
Yes.
And he always said, don't care about what a man says, only care about what he does.
Yes.
It's actions that matter. Words can't hurt you. Sticks and stones can break your bones, but words can never hurt you. And we have a society now where everybody cares about words. Donald Trump offended people with his tweets. Who cares? He created the greatest economy in history. I love the guy. He made me money. I bought nice things. I took care of my family. I took care of my kids. He was the best guy for small business and for middle-class Americans in the history of America. There's never been a better economy for middle-class Americans or small business. And you worry about his tweets? Now you got Joe Biden. The country's falling apart. We left Americans behind in Afghanistan. The border's got millions sick people with COVID waiting to get in. He says COVID's bad. I don't even, by the way, in the whole world, I know thousands and thousands of people, and I've only in my whole life ever met two that ever died of COVID. And this guy says, we should all be locked in our homes. We should all be masked. We should all be vaccinated. While he lets in millions of sick people at the border, none of them are checked. None of them are masked. None of them are vaccinated. And he's flying them all over the country, putting them in the Midwest with you. Are you kidding me? This is a disaster. Please bring us back Donald Trump, please.
So, Wayne, whatever, you know, you're an old school guy. You've been around long enough. You're a student of history. What the hell happened to Ellis Island? How come we don't have an Ellis Island anymore?
Yeah, well, remember, at Ellis Island, James, the first thing they did was check you for disease.
Yes.
If you had a disease, they sent you home. There was no compassion. They were like, oh, come on in. We'll put you in the hospital. We'll pay the $1 million bill. Are you kidding me? They stuck you back in the bottom of the boat and sent you home.
They're like, go home, and when you're well, come back.
Right. And if you come back and you've got disease, we'll send you back again. Well, right now, let's face it, liberals lie about everything. You know, for years I heard there were 12 million illegals in the United States, and they kept quoting that and quoting that, and they still quote it. And at the same time, I heard even Harvard did a study, and there may be as many as 32 million illegals in the United States. And if Harvard says it, that means there's probably 42 million. They're all liars. So now you have the head of DHS who says that maybe 20% of the people coming into the country at the border have COVID. You know what that means? It's probably 60%, 70%, 80%. They're all sick. They're all coughing. You know why? I'm not being mean to them. They've just had the most horrible journey in the world. The women have been raped every step of the way. And all along, the Mexican mafia is attacking them and asking them for money. And they're all exhausted from walking miles. And they all lived in abject poverty, and they've got nothing. So they've eaten no food. They don't take vitamins. They're all sick. And you're letting them into our country? Are you crazy? While you claim there's a pandemic going on? This is insanity. Biden is the pandemic. He's the COVID president. He's the one inviting COVID in and then busing them and training them and planing them all over the United States to infect you and me. So you're damn right there's now a pandemic. He caused it. He owns it.
It is Wayne Allen Root. He joins us today here in a broadcast. The Great Patriot Protest and Boycott book is now available. So, Wayne, what's been the feedback and reception you've gotten on this book so far?
Oh, it's fabulous. Everybody feels empowered. Everyone feels good that someone's trying to give them a solution instead of just complaining. I mean, anybody could point out the problems, and I'm really good at pointing out the problems, but that doesn't help you. You got to have solutions. So as an example, like here in Las Vegas, where I live, we're not like other cities. We're not like New York City or San Francisco or Chicago, right? We're not like that. We're not like Los Angeles, where they're trying to take unvaccinated people and isolate them. They can never go into a store again. In Vegas, so far, none of that has happened at all. So I've promised my fans, live on the radio, that the first restaurant that tries to put up a sign that says you can't come in if you're not vaccinated, I will bring 10,000 of my fans. We will lock arms in front of that restaurant and not let anyone in. It will come 20 nights in a row till we drive you into bankruptcy and drive you to your knees. That's the way we've got to take on the left, and that's how we're going to win. And I hope, James, it inspires people in Kansas with you and in other cities all over the country to do the same thing as me. You've taken this stuff lying down. You're allowing it to happen, and the left is trampling you and pretty soon you're not going to be allowed to eat out. You're not going to be allowed to walk in a grocery store if you don't take a stand now. So I'm all about Dr. Martin Luther King, civil disobedience. Any retail store in Vegas that tries to keep unvaccinated out, I will put them out of business. Me and 10,000 fans every single day till they're out of business.
That's amazing. I will have to say, you guys do an incredible job out there with customer service and everything. First time I went to Vegas, I'm like, my God, I got to live in Vegas.
It's a great city. And a lot of people think what you think. They come here on vacation, and they say, I'm going to move, and they come back. You know, right now in Vegas, you wouldn't even believe what's happening with houses. You know, if you put a house on the market, you're going to sell it in a day. It's going to have 30 offers, and they're all going to be $25,000 to $50,000 above your asking price. And they're all going to be people, sight unseen. They know if they try and wait to make an appointment to come see the house, they'll lose it. So they make an offer just with the pictures on the Internet. And we're selling houses in an hour or in a day at way above asking price. For every house that comes on the market, there's like 50 people that need a house because a whole California is moving here, and they're all willing to pay top dollar. So as an example, you know, a great friend of mine has a house that was worth $600,000 in a beautiful neighborhood in Las Vegas, and that house in 6 months has gone from $600,000 to $1.1 million. In 6 months, everyone in California is moving to Vegas. And they're moving here because California, run by Democrats, is a freaking disaster. And they're running away from California. And we have zero income tax in Nevada. And that's what they want.
Yes, yes. And the first time that we went to Vegas, we went somewhere. We were covering a convention at the Hard Rock. And we needed to pick up some material somewhere. And my girlfriend at the time, she's like, there's no sales tax. This is amazing.
We got some great advantages here. The sun's always out, and the ladies are beautiful, and the skies are always blue. A little hot in the summer. I can't stand June, July, and August, so I take my vacations in the summer. But 9 months a year, it's absolutely beautiful. And you can, you know, for the price of a closet in Los Angeles, you can have a house in Las Vegas, and it's a nice house. And you have, you know, very low property taxes and no income tax at all, no business tax, no inheritance tax, and no capital gains tax on your stocks. Pretty cool place to live. But, unfortunately, becoming much more Democrat, so that may change. And if it does, your friend Wayne Root will be headed to Texas. Trust me.
So, Wayne, now that this book is out there, what are some of the other things you're working on besides the radio show and other things?
Well, you know, I had the number one show on Newsmax for 3 years. It was in the prime time, 8 o'clock East Coast time, time slot, which would be 7 Central in Kansas.
Yep.
And I had Bill O'Reilly as my guest 3 times a week to open the show. And it was the number one show for 3 years and 750 episodes. And then I got in a little fight with the owner of Newsmax because I was too pro-Trump. How do you like that one? And so my contract was up. They let me go. I'm looking to get back on TV, and I'm working on it really hard now. So we'll see what happens. The trouble is, there's just so few conservative networks. There's nothing out there. It's Fox News, and it's Newsmax, and it's OAN, and OAN's very small. And that's all there is. That's it. So it's not easy, but I'm working on getting a new TV show, and I'm working on getting my podcast, you know, on video so you can watch it every week. So those are the kind of big projects on my mind right now.
Fantastic, fantastic. Well, Wayne, I will have to say that way back in the day when I used to watch you on the sports betting TV shows,
yes.
I never thought I'd ever be able to actually interview you because you were fantastic on those shows.
Well, I'm back in that world again, by the way. I'm doing that, too. I didn't even mention that. I took a company public on the stock exchange, and it's called Winners, Inc., and it's a company that gives advice with 21 world-class sports handicappers, of course, led by me, but 21 others besides me, my whole team of great sports handicappers at VegasWinners.com, and we sell you the picks. And here the guy who's Mr. Conservative and Mr. Trump fan and Mr. Great Patriot Protest and Boycott Book, you know, I do the football picket, and I'm 18 and 5, 78% winners in the NFL to start the season. Not bad, huh?
No, it's not bad at all. And I'll tell you, you are the man when it comes to the sports betting and everything else. How did you get involved with doing the sports betting?
Well, Well, you know, I was a kid growing up in New York, and what's that? You know, we're not in Kansas anymore. New York is not Kansas. All the kids would, you know, throw dice against the wall, play craps, and all the kids would be betting on football games. And I, you know, I took all their money. I cleaned out the house. I was as good as anyone ever saw. Every bet I made, I was winning. So, you know, when I was 16, I said, I'm going to be the next Jimmy the Greek, who was the big Vegas odds maker in those days on CBS TV, on the NFL pregame show. And I said, I'm going to be Jimmy the Greek. And fast forward from the age of 16 to the age of 26, I was hired by CNBC to be Jimmy the Greek's partner on a sports betting show. And my career exploded from there. So, you know, I was Jimmy the Greek's partner. You didn't get any better than that. I was the last guy he was ever partnered with on TV, and they actually fired him because they said, who needs him? Wayne Root is so good at talking. We don't need another guy on the show, and they fired Jimmy the Greek. So I actually, you know, ended his career. I ended my hero and idol's career, and I didn't mean to do it, but it just worked out that way.
It's amazing. It's amazing. Well, Wayne, it's been an honor and a privilege, and I know we've been trying to put this interview together for a couple years, so I'm glad we got some time, and this book is absolutely incredible. Have you had any success stories of people using this book to get some of these corporations to kind of change their tune on stuff?
Oh, yeah, the answer is yes, but remember, the book just came out 10 days ago, so it's brand new. So brand spanking new. You know how busy people are. They probably bought it, and they just got it in the last day or two, and they haven't even read it yet. But the few people that have contacted me who read it, and remember, it's a number one bestseller, so thousands have already bought it, but only a few have called me, emailed me and said, I read it. And those few all said they already got started sending out emails to the CEOs of the biggest companies in America that I give you their email. In this book, I got their private emails, and it's in the book, and they all said the CEOs answered them back. They were in shock that CEOs of billion-dollar companies answered them and said, don't boycott me. What can I do to stop you from boycotting me? Please don't boycott me. What did I do wrong? So if they answer one person, one conservative, here or there, can you imagine if this catches fire and hundreds of thousands of us or millions of us start contacting all these CEOs, it's going to change corporate behavior and change the culture of the United States of America.
It's amazing. Well, Wayne, thanks for doing this, my friend, and good luck with everything. And next time I am in Vegas here in several months, we'll have to link up finally in person, my friend.
You got it, James. The Great Patriot Protest and Boycott book by Wayne Allyn Root. You can buy it at Amazon, Barnes & Noble, or Target. Those are the places you buy books. Unfortunately, they're all pretty liberal, but there's no choice. You got to buy a book somewhere. Amazon sells like 90% of all books at this point. So whether you hate them or love them, you still got to buy your book there. But you know what? You can make a statement out of my book. Just don't buy anything else at Amazon ever again other than a conservative book. That's it. That'll make
That's
a statement.
Awesome.
That'll make a statement. All right, James, I got to run.
I appreciate it, brother.
God bless, my friend. Thank you.
Thanks for doing this. There he goes. That's Wayne Allyn Root, the fantastic Wayne Allyn Root. Thanks for joining us today here on our big broadcast. And we...